Sorry, guys. I don't know how else to get this done. I did it on my phone this time, but I can't upload it to an email because it's too big, and I can't figure out how to get it into like Google Drive. So I'm gonna do this so I can just get it done. So sorry.
The audience. Right. Is it ever okay for a 14-year-old to kill someone? Freddie Oversteegen says in the Times article from 2018, "We had to do it. It was a necessary evil, killing those who betrayed the good people." Most of you have been or know a 14-year-old girl. Could you imagine them being trained during war? I cannot. Freddie Oversteegen did unspeakable and heroic things simultaneously. She and seven more young girls fought together to bring down the Nazis. Many people, myself included, consider her to be a true resistance leader and a hero among young girls. In the book, Seducing and Killing Nazis by Sophie Poldermans from 1999, the author speaks about honor that was bestowed to the women. They were awarded the Mobilization War Cross in 2014, finally getting the recognition that they deserve. Telling her story seems like a fiction story, but it is all true. To tell you about Freddie, I have to give you a little background on what was going on in Europe during this time in history. This video clip from 1947, Shadows of Hate, by Alexander Street will show you just how awful it was during the Nazi reign.
In his notorious Nuremberg decrees, he deprived the Jews of their fundamental human rights. People for the Jews grew in proportion to their enthusiasm for the new order. Throughout Germany, persecution was systematic and merciless. Bands of stormtroopers roved the streets, beating and arresting Jews without cause. Property was confiscated, and the owners thrown into concentration camps.
World War II began September 1st, 1939, and ended on September 2nd, 1945. This terrible war was started because Nazi Germany invaded Poland without provocation. Many countries were involved, and millions of people died. Freddie's resistance story begins when the Nazis invaded her Netherlands home on May 10, 1940. Freddie Nadja Oversteegen, in the picture shown, was born in the village of Scrotem, which is now called Harlem, and experienced the war firsthand. She was born September 6, 1925, and was the second daughter to her mother and father. After her parents divorced, her mother raised her and her sister to have a good sense of social responsibility and was the one that gave her permission for her daughters to fight in the resistance. Knowing what Freddie Oversteegen was up against, she still didn't hesitate when the resistance came knocking. When you are recruited at age 14, you have to grow up fast. The recruiters taught her to shoot a gun, use dynamite to sabotage bridges and railroad lines. She also distributed pamphlets against the Nazis and seduced men. Killing those men was not an easy thing for her to do. It was a time of war, and she did what she needed to do to save lives. When asked about how many men she killed or helped kill, she replied in the Washington Post article 2018 by Harrison Smith, "One should not ask a soldier any of that." She struggled with this until the day she died. She died September 5th, 2018, just one day before. She believed until her last days she did what had to be done when she killed those men. Her Her sister Truis recalls that Freddy was the first of them to kill Mia. They shed many tears afterwards and then continued on their quest. Freddy and her family also hid refugees in their home and helped Jews get out of concentration camps. Hiding people was as dangerous as fighting on the front lines. The Nazi soldiers would conduct searches every night, and this terrified the girls. Even though Freddy was part of an 8-girl resistance group, she mostly worked with her older sister, Truis, and a friend named Hanny. These young girls would catch the eye of a Nazi soldier or Dutch trader in a bar, lure them into the nearby woods, and kill them. This resistance group would ride their bicycles through the villages, distributing pamphlets, all the while with a gun in their basket. They were never suspected to be a party of the resistance. They were young girls with long braids. Even wielding all those things, the girls still were scared of the soldiers when they would come for their nightly raids. Freddy Nadia Overstein was a hero who had to do unspeakable things for her country. Now that you know this story, I hope you can appreciate what those young girls sacrificed. Being a young girl during wartime was a great disguise to those she was fighting against. And having to get the job done and having the training was a blessing. And having the other young girls to help her fight made Freddy a hero. So the next time you hear somebody talking about World War II, you can tell them about the 14-year-old girl who saved many lives, became a soldier in the resistance, and was an absolute hero. Okay, I've got a pee in the audience.
All right, there you go. Have a good night.